Alright, and welcome back, I hope, to my Let's Play Warlords series. If you have already seen the first three parts, then there's not really much to explain, other than let's get on with it. And if you haven't, well, maybe you should see the beginning first. Well, let's load our game. And it was end of turn 15. So we move on to turn 16. Yeah, we kind of expected them. Dragons. They're tough. Okay, we successfully managed to defend one of these. Whoa! And... but not that one. Oh, that. Man, I'm... really bad at this game. I completely forgot. Whoa. All about... all his troops he had. Hmm. That's being declared war. Yes. He's moving in to bother me. Dragons galore. Everybody has dragons. Except us. Hmm. I don't appear to be too good at keeping my cities, but everyone else seems to be. I don't know why they keep insisting on attacking with only one guy, especially the weakest kind. We can't even take cities when we use a bunch of them, so... another hero. Well, this time he demands quite a bit of money, but we will accept because new heroes are always good and welcome. Yeah, I don't really need to give him any new names. Could actually just because I'm a moron. Just to fit with our theme. That means I should probably have called our second hero Percival, but nevertheless, there's not much to do about it. Okay, all of you, how do we look? Not too good, but we're not doing awfully bad either. This one is easily taken back. We can just use our wizards to do that, and they would still be placed quite conveniently, so let's do that. I shouldn't lose anyone with them, because they're quite strong. So let's hope for that. Just as planned. We get our city back, and we can start producing. Just so they don't get grouped with anything. We're just gonna put them right next to where the production are. This guy, he's going up here, I can see. Hmm. Two guys, you might not be able to deal with that, but maybe he will. I don't think he will, actually. This group is, should be able to, but... well, they need his help, or he should go do... well, he can't reach that one, I know that, so maybe he should just go help. Yeah, he should go help out. To ensure victory. What? Didn't even win a kill a single guy? That's... One of them was a cavalry. Oh man, that sucks. Man, we are really unlucky with our sieges. I mean, really. We should probably try to kill the dragon. And the best way to do that is get a hero and a bunch of dudes. Swarm it with bodies. We're potentially wasting a hero, but we can't just let them take it. Besides, that dragon is, well, it's never going to be the end of it. Keeps the city and the dragon alive, so. Wow! Okay, we're not completely lost. That was an excellent battle. We're actually apparently really good at taking back our cities. We're just really bad at stealing them from our enemy. Okay, that's a hero down there. We don't want to... Well, the heroes make their stacks better. So, hero versus hero. Fine. Elves are better than light infantry. That gives them an advantage if we are to clash with that one. But seeing as he's hiding out in the city, which gives him a defense bonus, I'm not all that keen on doing that. But helping out down here, I am. Because if I remember, there was nothing else but down there. Yep, those will not reach us next couple of turns. Not all that one. That's our new hero. Good to know. Oh yeah, dragons. We need to stay on defensive here. Two dragons. Damn, that's annoying. Okay. With a defense bonus, we might actually have a shot at taking out a dragon. So we'll just defend right there. And this guy... Yellow had two dragons as well, so where's the other one? I don't think we killed one. It's probably down there with a hero, so... We still need to look out for that, but we can take deal with that later, I think. Nothing coming for these, so I should either try and help defend against the orcs, of course. Dragons, or I should keep attacking storm giants. Well, my motto is attack, 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 attack. Well, it's not really my motto, but it's more my modus operandi. That's just how I do it around here. You, get out there and defend. We don't want no stinking dragons here. This guy is probably going out to defend as well, so... Let's let him. Once we repel all these attackers, all these, they were going up here, I think. It's a big group. We don't need that to defend. You need that one. Perfect. That one looks like knights cavalry, so we want to get up here and help out as well. Okay. This guy, let's send him over here. And then we have our hero. Let's inspect him. So I got a move 16. He's also quite fast. Our beginning hero only had move 12. But both our secondary 16. Wizard and wizard. Two more wizards. Okay. That's both good and bad, because more wizards. Wizards are really good, but and we could do much worse, but I was kind of hoping for something more. Maybe not dragons, but devils, perhaps, or something. Well, maybe those are the only ones that are better. I don't remember if demons might be strength 7. Wizards are strength 6. No, which you still can't see because my face is in the way. But you can trust me on that. I can. I'm fact checking right now. But looking at them, you can see right down here where it says strength. You can't see the number, but strength 6. Just like heroes are strength 5 and so on. So, and I think demons are strength 7. But they might not be. They might actually only be strength 6 and thus, because they aren't fast. They might actually be less useful. So maybe only devils, I think, are strength 8. And dragons are strength 9. Or maybe I'm just thinking of the second game. Maybe the max is strength 8. But that means those would be strength 7. Nevertheless, my disappointment might actually have been premature and uncalled for. To be honest. Because wizards are really good. No, we'll just defend as well here. Oh, he already explored that, didn't he? Yeah, he did last turn. We brought a hero to defend. Well, that means I have to check if that's the hero he. He hasn't got an extra hero, does it? Oh, he can produce giants down here. We want to take these cities. No, he doesn't seem to have another hero nearby. Let's check out the ruins. The white ones are those not taken, which is that. Than that. Okay, so we still have two ruins left to take here, and then we gotta go back. There. And there. Well, we won't really get much of. Well, we might get that one. That one is hidden behind mountains, so we won't get that unless we suddenly get a dragon, in which case we can make our hero flying, but joining up with that. We probably won't, so. Okay. We want to take this one. Hero and a big unit in the city, that's bad. But we have a hero as well. And he's strength 6. And he has inventory. The Staff of Might, which I'm unsure what. I'm not sure what it does, but supposedly since it doesn't improve our strength, we were strength 6 because of that throne we sat on right here. It probably increases the bonus to my stack, so we do this, we actually have a pretty good shot of killing and taking the city. So I'm gonna do it. Go, Lord Flashheart. Yeah! With only minimal casualties, only crappy light infantry, actually. Excellent. And we get another item. Let's see the production facilities first. Standard light infantry? Or... 3 turns for strength 5, move 14. That's pretty good. That's an extra turn over heavy infantry with the same strength, but 6 more movement is very useful. So we're gonna want to produce these, but maybe I should get some light infantry to defend first, because my hero kind of wanna leave. Let's at least get one. And we want him to take the item, the Orb of L'Oreal. Okay, that means we should review his inventory. I'm not sure why I should move him up and down. Oh, of course, he probably can only use one at a time, so we should give the other to one of our other heroes when we get the chance. But it's pretty good, we got a lot of value out of this attack. Killed, only lost, what, 2 light infantry, and got rid of got a town, a good one, a wolf rider, and another hero, and an item. That's pretty boss. Yeah, cavalry can stick here to defend. And there's actually a lot of movement left. But I'm not gonna be that suicidal, so yeah, we'll just stay here and go for the ruins and venture that library, the Crypt of Balls. Oh, maybe not that. I have terrible humor. No, we'll just wait. Yeah, I have been a little too aggressive with attacking my opponents, and haven't really paid off. It only really paid off when I knew there was a very high chance of winning. The rest of the time I've just been kind of gambling, and it hasn't really worked. Once it even worked when didn't work when it should, so no, we're gonna keep these here. We're definitely gonna keep that one here. Him, yeah, we need to move him out. There's no need to defend right there, at least not yet. And I should, of course, I should use these wizards to either attack up here, or maybe it would be better to help out over here, grab these cities. I know. I think I just gotta really kinda deal with the storm giants first and foremost. So maybe they should attack that one. They might be able to reach it. I don't know. We'll see. Oh, you certainly won't when you go through the hills for no reason. Damn. I should have thought of that. I should have remembered that the pathfinding isn't the greatest in this game. Well, maybe these can reach next turn, so we get some stronger forces instead. We are just gonna keep moving with these guys. And these. What are we attacking? No, that's a hero. Those are strong. Hero and strong. Oh, come on. That's strong defenders as well. That's probably the easiest one. That's not easy. Okay, he's just really well entrenched apart from down here, so I'm gonna have to move down here. That's really annoying. Yeah, he ain't gonna. I won't let him take us in. Well, we'll try again. This time it will hopefully work. It should have last time. This time it worked. Even better than I expected, without a single casualty. And all we can get is more of these. But so we should do that. Our plan is here probably to grind him down with light infantry, to surround as much of his cities and just grind him down with light infantry until he's got weak defenses, then send in something strong. That's the plan from now on, because I need to be a little less greedy. Of course, plan is to take that city. Quite possibly with this guy right here. Can you make it? 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, he should. Yep. There's no guarantee he'd win, but he probably will. Perfect. Doing great. Ooh, we can get more of these now. Still the same. What about these? 5 turns and only strength 5. Awful. I'm gonna have a lot of troops to try and deal with our opponents that way. Next unit. More cavalry. Excellent. We'll need it. We will most certainly need it. I think we'll need it against the orcs, of course, so gonna go that way. And I'm gonna have to remember to hold their hands when they're moving fast. But that's it for turn 16, which went really well. We made some playing mistakes earlier, but we made up for this time, playing hopefully right and lucky. Okay, on to turn 17. Let's see what's going on. We are being attacked, which he didn't stand a chance. Same deal. Still not lost anything. We shouldn't either here, but we might. Nope. He's doing our thing, tanking too little. He might win. He did not. We got lucky. Okay. I don't understand why they usually, if I recall correctly, they're usually better at grouping up their armies into stacks. I haven't really been doing that this game in the highest difficulty. I don't know what's going on. Or maybe we're just not at a point in the game where they do that yet. What you could expect, it's a dragon. But he leaves the town unguarded. That's good for us. These battles don't really matter much to us yet. He declares war on us. Wonder why. It's not really important because it isn't very consequential. to us. At least not to our war efforts right now. So we get a fourth hero. Wow. Kind of regret complaining in the beginning of the game that we were short in heroes where no one else were, because they're just coming. Apparently all the money we have makes us really attractive employers. Yeah, he's gonna get the name Percival, because... Or maybe, no, we're gonna stick with Percival. And he brings two allies as well. Excellent. No, end report. We need more. We need it over here, because... Damn. Those dragons. We're gonna have to find a way to kill them. Okay, this guy. He's moving 7. He apparently got better for some reason. He's going over here. I don't think I'm gonna try all that. How long on there? Those getting giants. Gonna be a huge boost. So, moving out. And these are going the same way. Well, they're probably going up here. Nothing wrong with pressuring different places. Okay, where are the dragons? There's one there. And there. It's probably going down here. Which I can't really do much about, except... hope that's my... infantry... will do a good job at defending. Can't even counterattack that dragon because it's flying over the lake. I wouldn't want to anyway, all things considered. I have a higher chance of beating it when I'm in the city, so we're just gonna stay there for the most part. We're gonna check what he has with him. The group move was only 12, I noticed, and his is 16, so he probably has some powerful stuff. We have ghosts. Ghosts are strength 7. I only thought they were strength 6. That's very nice. Ghosts. Very powerful. I mean, we're gonna have a super group right here ready to move out once I figure out what to do with those dragons. So he won't move out late. Until later. He'll just defend right here. And so will he. Kind of annoying to have these powerful heroes and not be able to do much with them, but when you're being pressured by dragons, that's kind of where you're at. Alright, we just keep marching this way. Why hasn't he reduced anything in all these turns? Is he really spending time producing something really... really strong, or just really terrible? Who knows? We are certainly gonna try and deal with it. We're gonna try and take it from him. We cannot fail.
Okay, we can. We probably fail now, but still, attack!
Excellent. Well, not excellent to lose cavalry, but excellent when you didn't lose wizards. It takes 3 turns to produce heavy infantry. Oh, that's kind of lame. And they're even slower than usual. God, that's terrible. And these are just standard. Well, we're going to produce those for a while. Least. I'm feeling lucky. I'm gonna go over here and take this city as well. Or at least try. Hopefully I'm not wasting my wizards. I was not. Excellent. Further expansion. Tinker drill. 8 turns to reduce calorie. Wow, they got a... Wow, that's awful. Awful. Why are these cities so bad? All they're good for is mass producing small guys. Well, if that's all we need, I guess I can accept it. Right now is all we need. Feels like I got all the crap cities apart from, well, my beginning ones, because they make elves. Those are good. A lot of guys. Seeing as Wolf Riders are strength 5. We'll just stay here for a while still. And we have a dragon incoming, so we'll stay here, and we want him to help out over here, so we're still not being pressured down here, so we move on. There. Well, there is one good thing about having to keep my heroes put. That is, I actually get to give them the large armies they really deserve, so that they can become unstoppable juggernauts. Yeah. Well, they won't really be unstoppable, but you get the picture. Okay, let me just keep moving. Don't want to attack the hero, do we? We might. No, we want to wait. We want to wait a bit. That's a dwarf. Right. That was off the defense, and he was going down here. So he gets to search the ruins. Yeah, there's only one giant in each of those stacks, but giants are still tough. After all, a single giant managed to take one of our cities with 3 arches in it. Shouldn't underestimate power like that. And that's it for turn 17. I'll just save, and seeing as I'm spending a really long time on these turns, I think I'm gonna end this session right here at the bottom of turn 17. But I'll be back shortly. See you then.